Hey, what's up, Blender users? I'm Jonathan, and now that my biggest videos are about smoke and liquid simulations, I think it is time to talk about Embergen. If you haven't heard about it, Embergen can create real-time smoke simulations, which you can also export as VDB files to Blender. And with their beta release, they gave everyone a 2-week free trial, which supports VDB export. So let's just open Embergen and see what the software allows us to do. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said and done, let's get straight into the video. Now, with Embergen open, you can see that this is what we get. We have a few windows right here. Down here, this is the timeline. We have our 3D viewport, in which we can navigate around. We have our panel for customizing the nodes, and we have our node tree. You can see that this is the standard scene, and if I just press space to play the animation, you can also see that we get this simulation. All this runs on the GPU, so it is pretty fast. Now, this of course isn't a great simulation, but it is real time and we get a pretty realistic combustion simulation right here. Now, let's go through this. If you press play and want to go back to the first frame, you can for example press R to reset the simulation. In your node tree, you can see that we always start off with a shape. You can add nodes by right clicking in this panel. And under shape, you can see that we get the options primitive, mesh, noise, particles, modifier, and blend. For example, we can now choose particles and get a new node, and we can plug the shape output in the shape input. Now this emitter node uses both inputs, and if we press play, you can see that we get particles and our spherical fire. Now the emitter output goes into the simulation input, where we can for example add forces and colliders. To add colliders, we can for example add in a mesh shape node. There you can open a mesh file. This shape output now should go into a collider node, right here, and you can then plug the collider output into the collider input. But we will take a look at this in a preset which Embergen creates for us. Now, everything that comes after the simulation node is just for the viewport right here. We have our light, our volume, our whole scene node, the camera, and the capture node. But we as Blender users only really care about the simulation node, because if we right click and choose the export VDB option, you can see that this uses a simulation input. This means that we can use this output as our export VDB input, and then we can define a file name and a place to store the files, and then hit export now. But we won't do this with this simulation. We will use a preset which is made by Embergen's team. So let's go to File, Open Project, and you can see under Presets a bunch of presets which were all pre-made. Now let's for example use this Shed preset. Select it and hit Open, and you can now see that we get this scene. We have this little model right here which was imported, and if we press play, you can see that the explosion wraps around the 3D model, because this is a collider right here. Now you can see in the timeline we have these little dots. These are animated parameters. You can animate every parameter by just for example clicking on the node and then clicking on this icon. This will now add the ability to animate this property. But we do not really need this, because we will just use this as our export. Now let's add in our export node, right click, export and VDB, and plug the simulation output into the input right here. Let's click on this folder icon and choose a place where you want to store the files. Now we have to assign a name for these files, and for this tutorial I'm just going to use test. Let's press save, and you can see that our final file name will be test.###, which is the frame number. Now we can choose how many frames we want to export, and for this I'm going to choose 100. You can click into every panel and just type in whatever you want. Now, for this simulation, I also want to export the temperature and fuel, just because we can easily use these values in Blender. Great, now we can hit export now. This will take some time and it's not completely real time, but you can see how fast this is exporting. Okay, great, now we can hop over to Blender 2.83, which allows us to import VDB files. Now with Blender open, let's select everything and delete it, and then Shift A volume and choose import OpenVDB. Let's locate our folder where we saved our VDB files and press A to select everything and import this. Now you can see that nothing has happened, This is because we have to play our animation. And there it is. You can see, because we don't have the shed, the smoke looks a bit weird, but this is okay for this tutorial. To really see where our simulation is, we can go into wireframe mode. This will allow us to see the outlines. And I really want to scale this down, just because this is way too big. Now we have our simulation, but because everything we saw on the viewport came after the simulation node, we have to assign every material in Blender. So let's go to Cycles and switch to GPU. And now, for a little tip, to get a realistic skybox, you can just search for sky in the add-on preferences and check dynamic sky. And now in the end panel under create, you can see this dynamic sky option. Hit create and choose the dynamic sky in the world properties. And now you have a pretty realistic sky, which gives us some nice lighting. Let's just quickly assign the materials. Go to the shader editor, select your volume and press new. You can of course create your own volume shader, but for this tutorial we will just use the principal volume, which I feel like gives a good result most of the time. Now let's go into rendered view, and by just adjusting the blackbody intensity you can see that this happens. This is because we are right now using the temperature attribute, and you can actually preview all the attributes by just clicking on them. For example, flames looks like this, fuel is this, and temperature is this. And you can see temperature is the blockiest one. So let's for example select flames, and you can start to see some red light appearing in our smoke. We can for example up the temperature to let's say 4000 to get nice fire in our smoke. You can also up your blackbody intensity just like this. If I would now go ahead and type in fuel, you can see that this is the look we get. The fire is the hottest right here, where it comes out of the shed and becomes cooler in the front right here. So for this, I think I like the look of flames the most. And now we should be able to render out this simulation. One quick tip, if you think your simulation looks too low res, you can always go here in the simulation node and adjust the voxel count. The highest is 512 by 512 by 512. But you can also use upscaling and upscale it times 4, which also adds a lot of nice detail. But keep in mind that this can easily crash your PC, or at least the program, because this is pretty heavy on your GPU. Now, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing, and we will see us next Saturday in the next video.